Okay. I have not even tested this one. I've just downloaded it. And, you know, seen pictures of it. But it seems to be heavily inspired by an older TRLE that I used to really like, so I think I can dig it. Okay, so this is Jean-Yves' desk, I guess. Wow. First secret. That was quick. Sup, Lars? How you doing? It's me? What you mean? Just had a nice pizza. I got some leftover pizza that I can microwave. Plan to do at some point. Oh, Christ. Killing dogs is not okay. Hey, pure self-defense. Besides, you're a fox. Don't dogs usually, like, mess up foxes? Maybe that's not a super establishes thing. Establishes thing. Maybe that's not a super established thing. But... alright, this is probably going to kill me, but I got to try it anyway. Oh, never mind. It actually, you see, nice trick there. It actually made me not take fall damage when I would have if I'd just done it like that. See, that made me take a bunch of damage, but since I swan dived, I didn't. Now, that only worked because I bounced off of the ceiling in that way. By the way, that trick is not considered a glitch, is it? Okay, maybe I'm not 100% sure about that. I thought it wasn't considered a glitch, but perhaps it is. I doubt it. Okay, right, so we got keyhole of a deal. Something tells me I can only open this from the other side. Just somersaulting down the sidewalk. I wonder if I can use that as a tightrope or something. Wait, can I just climb this? No. Not quite. Oh. I wonder if I was supposed to jump through one of those windows. Because if that's the case, I could just reload. Okay, no, I definitely can't do that. But maybe I can go somewhere else? Probably not. Ow. See if I missed anything in here. Probably did. Sup, Ricardo? Alright, probably did not miss much here. Oh, I didn't even try running down this street. This is this week's edition of Stuck on literally the first task of a custom level, even though it's extremely self-explanatory. Oh, those are all keys. Or no, wait. I don't know what the hell those are. They're like, they're tools. They're too big to be keys. Ship. Oh. Well, this one's got a small door, so that means I can open it. Ah! Shit, dog. You can't use the rolling trick on these guys. Really. Because they could just pivot. The trick you usually use in Tomb Raider 4 to not take damage from those guys is have the shotgun. What? Shit. Oh, it's really far away. In fact, he's so far away that I could probably shoot him from here. Gotcha, bitch. I didn't even have to use manual aim just because he was too far away to lock onto. That trick does not work in the other game engines, by the way. I'm pretty sure that's only a Tomb Raider 4 thing. Shit! Alright, well, I fucked that up. Aw, man! I fucked up before I even fought anyone. That's typical. I mean, I didn't save after killing those guys. I had a feeling I was going to have to fight human enemies. By the way, I didn't see what else was at the end of this hallway. Oh, God. More floors, I guess. Huh. That seems like a pedestal with nothing in it. Or maybe a drawer on one side. Kick that door open. Okay, well, I know from Nightmare in Vegas that there's usually a key in the bathroom. Okay, I guess it's just a health pack. It's almost like it's something that kind of makes sense to be in a bathroom. Bye! Well, I like revolver ammo. But I also like exploring a new area for more than just one pile of ammo and a small health pack. Maybe there's something else there that I missed, but whatever. It's time for combat! Jesus. Is there an item there? Guess not. Jesus. Okay, you know, Uzi ammo is great, but I gotta get them Uzis. It's almost like the game wants me to shoot this guy from a distance. Ah. Jeez. This is a shitty strat. Let's see if I can do it while taking less damage. Somehow I did it with less damage in the first attempt, so... I don't know. Can't believe I'm redoing a part of the game because I took a little damage. That's so stupid. And typical. Coke get. Nice. So is there really nothing else over here? Okay. Managed to avoid most of that damage. Pretty sure? Wait, what double doors? They weren't double doors, they were just these. Right? That's what you call gaming with one finger. Oh, it looks like he can sort of be dodged. Or at least you can sort of make him turn around all weird. Lots of little bonus items around here. Hey there, Spoder. It's going all right. Started the stream just a minute ago. Now, those leaves look weirdly high resolution for this type of level, but... yeah. Indeed. Let's see. Where the hell? He's there. More high resolution climbable walls. Okay. This is really stupid, but if you climb it like this, it's just a tiny bit faster. Obviously, going back and changing the way you climb it is slower. But you know what? Well, obviously I can shimmy around there, but let's see what's in here. If anything. Oh. Oh, please be something other than just that. Good lord. Okay, I'm not sure where that is down there. Oh, okay, this is... never mind, I do know where that is. That's where I picked up the large health pack. So is there nothing over here other than the flares? No. There's just so many health packs in this place. My god. I think it's kind of clever how we managed to include slope geometry that would make you stuck if you could get to it. What is it with the cum and the health packs? They're just health packs. The first aid you've been using might be not be the right kind. Okay, got it. Wait a second. Okay, never mind. I actually can't shimmy past that. Probably because it's a tight rope? Or is it not? No, I guess not. It's just a solid object. Or maybe a swingable pole. I don't know. All you need is love. All you need is love. Love. Cool. Anyway, where the fuck? Okay, it's definitely not a tightrope, but... oh, I can just jump across here, can't I? I didn't even think I could make that for some reason. Da-da-da-da! There we go. Giant ass key. All right, I guess now I can just go back down. Okay. Where the fuck? Trying to see if that's a place I've already been to. Probably is. Oh my gosh, yeah, all of these places are practically. Wait, maybe I haven't been down there? But yeah, mainly I just need to get. You know my idea is good? No, it's not. It's just not. let's see. Freaking jazz club. Oh, shit. You're sad now? Good. Anyway, where's that damn keyhole? Oh yeah, it was back this way. Assuming that's the same keyhole. Toxic streamer. Still the goddamn keyhole I had seen this whole time. Also, that is a really weird door for a jazz club, I'm just gonna say. Jesus Christ. Can I lure them out? All right. Maybe this will work. So many health packs. Oh. You like jazz? Yeah, jazz is alright. I don't have just too much like knowledge of it. I just know like the freeform jazz sounds very different from, like, orchestrated jazz. But it can still be good. Ah! Aha. Oh, these are pushable, aren't they? Huh. These look the same as the pushable ones. I guess they ain't. Oh. All right, then. Ah. That's one of those things where I'm supposed to get a damn revolver, but you can just not use a revolver and shoot it. Don't tell me I'm going to find a revolver in here. Oh. Now hang on a second. Supposing I hadn't found the revolver yet, what was I supposed to do here? And she is moving. Okay. Maybe it was in here. Doink. Everyone knows that people leave revolvers in bathrooms. Oops. Okay, so it doesn't have the thing. That's okay, I guess. I thought that sounded fine. Was there supposed to be something there? Probably was. I've never really watched SpongeBob. I would probably enjoy some of it, though. Yeah, for all I know, all of the random SpongeBob clips I had seen on TV might have been from after that. Which maybe that's why I had a negative impression of it or something? I don't know. I didn't have that negative impression. I was just not into modern cartoons as much. Oh. Ah, we gotta do the thing with the stuff. Well, there's not even anything on that table. Oh god, I hope he didn't drop anything important down there. I guess not. Oh, flares. Don't mind if I do. Yoink. Wait a minute. I wonder if I can... Didn't seem like it, but I'm going to just check if I can push any of those. Looks like sprinklers. I'm supposed to shoot that. Let's see, isn't there like a glitch where you can... Yeah, never mind. Okay. So the sprinkler's on. Oh, that meant this opened. Okay. Why not? Gosh, if I wasted all my revolver ammo, I would just be shit out of luck for that part. Wait, is there extra revolver ammo here or something? There is, of course. Oh, I didn't even notice that. No way, there isn't a thing. Never mind. I thought I noticed something, but I didn't notice something. Because I need something other than just the... Oh, I already have that. I didn't even realize that I had the carjack already. You know what's great, though? I keep thinking I'm going to have to search these shelves, Tomb Raider Chronicles style. And I don't. Because this is obviously Tomb Raider 4 style. Alright, well, that's just a button. Oh. Shit. Oh, this is the door I was at before that couldn't open... from the other side. Please, motorbike. Please, motorbike. Please, motorbike. Alright then. No motorbike. Hadn't saved it in a long time for some reason. Oh. Couple random pickups. I don't suppose you can climb these, huh? Wait a minute. No. Oh. Whee! Okay, the camera fixed itself. Now, wait a minute. Would I just fall through that if I ran? No, it's at least not making me fall through, so that's good. And that's a curtain. Is there nothing I can do here? I can't do nothing with this cupboard. Whatever. Wait. I assumed I couldn't do anything with this, but... Oh, shit. Almost missed that. Tomb Raider 4 mechanics. Watch it be a secret. Well, it was harder to find than the secrets. Alrighty then. I push the button. Oh, fuck. NBD, guys. Sup, Game Raider. Ah! All right, well, we didn't miss much. Oh, that's what changed. There's a rope now. I assume these guys will not spawn. Shit. I can't see shit. I just gotta check if he dropped anything. Oh, he did drop something. Dropped something very good. Okay. But first of all, did I already try opening... I guess that's right. This is because it's the doggo. Alright, you know what? Cumber? Oh, you mean like cumbersome? Well, this seems like there's going to be a rolling ball somehow, but maybe not. All right, 1 second. I got a BRB. Okay. Welcome back. Oh, come on. I didn't save from this again. What a bunch of bull crap. White people do season, it's just that they use salt and pepper exclusively for some reason. So there's like no variety to anything. I mean, they have entire shops around the world for different types of curry. Where it's just a whole shop for curry. And there's just like rows and rows of shelves of all different products that are all curry, but they're different things. In the US, you just got, okay, curry powder. That's it. Occasionally, you can maybe get a slightly spicier curry powder variant, though I don't usually see that anymore. Now, hold on a second. How did I even... Oh, I get it. That's right. I forgot I shimmied around the walls. All right. See ya. Ugh. Fucking pisses me off when I waste an ammo. Ow. And now I've wasted a health. You know what? I don't care. Using a goddamn health pack. Whatever. I was trying to go all no meds about it somehow. All right, fuck it. One more time. I'm doing it one more time. I can't goddamn believe this. This is gonna waste a lot of time that I don't have to screw around, but I just... Okay, Jesus Christ. Remember to goddamn save the game this time. What? Just run forward, you won't miss the dog. And then this is where I was when I freaking... Oh, wait, I just realized something. I need to... If I restart this and run it in 32 bits, I won't have that weird delay before saving. Hang on, I just want to try something real quick. Alright, create shortcut, edit shortcut... So that it's set up. And now... Huh. 32, 16. Okay. Let me just see if it works. Oh, God. Okay, so maybe 32-bit is the problem. So I just need to change it from 32-bit to 16-bit. And then that's the only change I gotta make. Probably. So 16-bit didn't fix that problem at all. Never mind. Anyway, whatever. Oh, this is a little bit close to the wall, and because of that, you could do this. Yeah! Nice. I guess you can't really do much. But yeah, that's the problem with Tomb Raider 4 ropes. If you put anything within, even if there's even a wall that close, you can use it to glitch to the top of the wall if there's anything on top of that. But I mean, that's kind of a rare scenario. Okay. Holy shitballs. Okay, well, I completely... Are you kidding me? I don't know how I fucked that up. Okay, well, before I do this, before I kill you, Mr. Bond, what the hell was in this other room? Was it, like, nothing that I can even do? At all? Like, is there a pushable thing? Alright, I assume I'll just go back this way at some point. Okay. This time we won't completely go insane and overshoot. Just swing along. Swing normally. Shit. Doink. Give me them Uzis. I gotta find them. I got so much Uzi ammo, goddammit. Okay. This will just let me head out on the ledge. Is there anything... Okay, I guess I can also use this window if I... if there is any advantage to doing so. It's like, I could technically get on that roof, but then it wouldn't matter, really. Okay. What? Right, well, I guess I can go down here because there's a little box to climb back up. Where are you, bitch? Probably shouldn't have free-aimed that, but... I trust it a little more than Lara's aim sometimes at long distances. Because she just misses things. Especially in this game, I want to say. But I don't know. Maybe it's pretty similar mechanics in all of the games. Okay. Okay, now this is a really dark corner. Maybe it's got something in it. I don't know. Also a dark corner. Didn't check whether that guy dropped anything, but... There you go, that was the one door that I had found. And this place is empty. Oh shit. So many bad guys in this level. I got it. Check this area out. See if I can find any hidden things. Unless I've already done that, I might have. Shit. Maybe not. Just looking for some sort of hidden item or something. But I guess we're good. Oh, why did I have a feeling that was going to be a level transition? I guess because it was in darkness, but then I was like, no, probably not. It'll just lead to some little room or whatever. But no. Now I'm here. And where's here? Mary Laveau? Marie Laveau. Oh. Oh, here we go. This is the other thing from Fading Light. The cemetery. Well, Fading Light also borrowed textures from other stuff, I guess. Well, obviously something's gotta happen with that. Holy shit! Obviously, I gotta find a torch. Oh. Whoops. I've had a feeling that would happen. Oh, I guess I can't open that one from this side. Interesting. Okay, maybe that didn't do a lot for me. Obviously, you gotta jump somewhere else. Like over there. That's like the obstacle course jump. Alrighty then. I feel like I'm probably missing secrets and shit, but whatevs. What the hell? Well, that's just strange. Oh. Huh. Of course. Ah, here we go. Finally. I got my damn Uzis. Obviously, they're in a goddamn sarcophagus in a tomb. Oh. And I finally got that. I can't get close to that fire, though. I'm pretty sure it's the type that can light me up. They are so pathetically slow. But again, I have seen a mummy enemy. I guess it was in Ghosts of Croft Manor. The suits of armor actually poison you if they touch you. So that makes them just a much more significant threat. Like, they don't even have to hit you. They just have to come into contact with you. And you're poisoned. Deadly to light the bad guys up. Yeah, it'd be pretty sweet. Oh, hi. Lars. Welcome back. Anyway, how's your sex life? There was a torch somewheres. Eh. Probably worse. It seems you're the expert, Mark. In here again? This is where I came from, or I don't even remember. Oh, but there were things to light here. Maybe. Or not. Okay, fine. Okay, can I actually get into this one? I haven't tried this one. Looks like I can. Huh. Oh, there's a torch. It's gonna make a spooky ghost come out, I assume. Or not. Nah, I'm good. But Lara is welcome too, I guess. Just gotta find more torches, I guess. Oh, maybe I can light something that's way on top of... Oh, actually, I can see that one. Interesting. Oh! Okay, I thought I was gonna fall down into the crypt completely. Nice. Actually, maybe that door that I couldn't open from that side is a secret. Or no, it was this one, so it's probably from inside the house or something. I don't know. I keep blanking on where that place even was. Is it this one? Yeah. Why is this? Somehow this is suspicious. Oh, Jesus Christ! Well, will it activate again? Or no? Well, I gotta see what's going on with... Oh. Maybe there's sea crests. Oh. Alrighty then. Well, we find another... find another weapon. Just more ammo. That's pretty sweet. Alright, now why do I feel like there was something else back? Oh no, I was just considering going back for the torch, but... I don't know, maybe I should, maybe I shouldn't. Maybe I shouldn't. Wow, this is probably gonna kill me. At least the first couple times. Oh, I get it. It's one of those things where... You're so slow at doing these things. Jesus Christ. It's a combination of two of the mechanics. You're so slow. Oh my God. That's terrifying. Because you obviously have to get the shotgun ammo. You can't just skip it. I don't even have a shotgun yet. I have Uzis and not a shotgun. Imagine that. Oh. That did not seem like the type of door to open straight up, but... You know, I get it, I guess. Now, what if this is also a trap somehow? I don't know why I don't trust it, but... Okay. Oh, now we're just back here. Oh. Well, I know exactly where to take that feller. Youch. Youchy wouchy woo. Okay, there we go. Get the fuck out of here. Die, monster! Alrighty. Now I'm here. Are you kidding me? Don't know if I'm really supposed to take the torch all this way, but meh. This is one of those boxes that don't have collision for some reason. Don't really understand that. Just checking the corners. Oh my. Water. This is our first water in this level. Which is a good thing, by the way. Because, you know, fuck water. What's it ever done for us? Oh boy. Oh boy. This is some, Temple of Karnak shenanigans, huh? Or not. Water's useless, am I right? Oh my god, now this is an interesting twist. On the, Tomb of Semerkat. Semerkat stuff. Because it's like, on the one hand, you got some water to dry you. I mean, to put your flaming body out. But you got visitors. Are you kidding me? Alright, well, I think something might have opened. Did this turn off permanently, or just... Alright, now did something else open when I actually did the thing? I'm not sure. What? Didn't something open just now? I guess it was a different door. Go to horny jail. Do not pass go. Do not collect your 200 cum. or whatever. Well, it's not how you actually are, it's how your actions speak for you. But, I mean, that's fair enough. It's just... Wait a minute, are you telling me I'm gonna have to go all the way back to some shit? Well, that was a somewhere. Oh, nice. Be gone. yeah, we realize that. It's not like we are confused about whether or not you were horny. It's just that when, like, nobody says anything in response to your jokes for, like, 30 minutes, like, then I guess people aren't going to laugh at the cum thing that much. I don't know. But I mean, it's not like we're the police of what you're allowed to make jokes about. I mean, like you said, you're bored. We're all just doing whatever. I don't know. I just feel like it wouldn't be out of place in probably most Twitch streams. I just can get a little awkward. What the fuck is that clipping? What clipping? Oh, I assume the thing where one of the textures is freaking out. Somehow this circular staircase room reminds me of a Harry Potter game. Ugh, I don't even... Whoop. Oh, yeah, this is so... I practically have been ignoring it because I've seen three coffins like this now. But it is a little bit inexcusable, I guess. But I guess most people wouldn't just, like, I'm going to run into this coffin to see if I can run through it the way I can. Okay, is this the goddamn thing I... Oh my god. PS1. Oh, PS1, I missed that part. That's the crazy thing. I grew up on the PC version and it's completely fucking different. I don't know what I mean, I'm sure that they have pros and cons, but the PS1 version is just, all the versions of Harry Potter on the different consoles are just wildly different games, and it's kind of astounding. Because it'll be like the same game. Chamber of Secrets, PS1, PS2, PC. All totally separate titles, but they're all the Chamber of Secrets. I mean, I guess there was a lot more of that in general with movie-based games back in the 2000s. Back in the 2000s, goddamn. Alright, I need to attend to something IRL. Important duties. I will be back in a few minutes. All right, Lars. Thanks for hanging out. Have a good night. Well, now I'm up here. Oh. Gross. Hey, wait a minute. I can make that jump, but then I guess I wouldn't be able to go anywhere from there. Yeah, it wouldn't really accomplish much. Mm-hmm. Goodness gracious. Oh my god, and then there's the jump switch. Am I gonna have to backtrack? Or no, I guess my goal is just to get over there. Ow, Jesus Christ. Guess I'll go over there. What's on the other side? Oh, can't go there yet. I just realized that looks like a lion with, like, teddy bear Mickey Mouse ears on top of it. Well, that was a monkey swing. Perhaps I can get something by jumping over here. Or perhaps not. Fine, I guess. Wait, I could just climb up from here? Yeah. Oh. We got them blade traps. And why is there a ladder thing here? Oh dear. Is that a room I've already been to? Looks like it. Yeah, it's that place with the things and the stuff. You know the one. First of all, there's no ladder on this side, right? Yeah. Okay. So what did I get? I got the thingy. Scripture. Oh, that's cool. I'm pretty sure this is the raw cartouche piece or something. I don't know how you say that. Carto, the thing that you stick in a thing in Tomb Raider 4, which is not very descriptive. But they retextured it to just be a goddamn Bible or whatever. Some manner of scripture anyway. Oh, it goes down there, I guess. Where the hell was that again? Good lord. Oh, I guess it was here. Maybe? Was it here? Oh, I guess I have to light this on fire or something. Wait, what? Huh? Torches? Maybe? Somewheres? I did not bring the torch in here. But what the hell? Oh, they're just pushable boxes. Maveable? I almost said maybe, and I was trying to say movable at the same time. Maveable? Let's see here. Wait, what? Not sure what these little pits in the floor are. Unless I have already been here and this is a different door than the one I'm thinking of. But it seems like the right one. I don't know. Let me see. Ugh. Okay, that's too far back. Reminds me I have to save in the most useless places. I can't get out that way.
Sip.
It's the kitty cat. Has been let in by my sister. Hey. How did I just go in and out of here immediately? Right, it was this place, the Harry Potter room. How am I even doing on flares? Pretty good. No, I'm just back here. Oh, God. I definitely remember going here already. Hey there. Kitty cat is just over here. Just to the right of the screen. You guys can't even see her. Whoa, whoa, do not try to walk over here, though. You are not going to do that. So what the F? Is this even the right place? I don't know how this is so confusing to me. Jesus Christ, it was that door that opened. It's not even the right one. There she is. Yeah, you can climb up here. She's now rubbing her face against the mic stand. Goodness. That's a lot of purple. Now she's going to start meowing for me to let her out of the room. Oh boy, don't tell me there's a goddamn underwater lever. Oops. Well, didn't really take damage, so I guess I'm alright. Oops. Ah! Oh, come on. Jeez. So many poles. And that's one of those coffins that you can just kind of run through. Seems to be just for show, though. Was that just a health pack and nothing else? I haven't found any secrets in this level. Oh wait, maybe I found one. I don't remember now. Hoo boy. Finally. Uh-oh. Oh! Oh! Holy shit. Holy shit. Well, that's one way to gracefully dive down into the water. Now, hang on a minute. What is this? Well, there's this underwater door that I never opened. Can I just open it by hand? No. Well, that bothers me just a little bit. Probably missed the secret lever that opens it, or whatever. We'll see. Maybe I didn't. Oh. Jeez. Startled me. If you could make the jump from there to here, I feel like you might be able to, theoretically. Easy peasy. Oh, does they have a jump switch or something? Oh. Oh, shit balls. I don't think I can really climb the ladder. So I guess I just gotta go back to where there's water. Which is not that far away, I guess. Are you kidding me? Well, I didn't mean to fall like that, but I guess this is a way to get items. Alright, Game Raider. You have fun. Oh, this just leads back here. Great. Got crossbow arrows out of it. Or bolts, rather. Ha! I keep running right past that shit. Okay, so I guess I'll climb stuff. Are you kidding me? There's just a closed trapdoor anyway. Alright then. Oh, wow. I didn't even notice that these things were obviously pushable. Okay. Okay. Gotta do the light thing. You know what I mean. Oh yeah, we gotta move three of them around. Where's the third one, though? Oh, I see. Great. Well, I just gotta figure out which ones have to be where. I guess that one would go over there, and that one... No, wait, that one would go over here. And then the other one, I guess, would go over there? Okay, great. They all gotta go where it's far away from. Oh, don't you just love that sound? It's just the best. Okay, maybe I overshot a little.
know. I guess that's...
might be right. Okay, maybe it's wrong. I would think there would be like a laser or some shit. If it was in the right place. Oh, for goodness sake. Okay, fine. Is this one at least right? Okay. I guess it doesn't necessarily give a super clear indication of whether they're right. I imagine that that one was correct. Okay, there we go. Now suddenly they just turned into lasers. They done turned into the lasers. Oh, for God's sake. Since I can't check my Uzi ammo just by drawing them. Wow. Well, now I can finally go up that thing. Okay, then. Huh. Oh, shit.
Huh.
Well, something tells me I'm gonna have to go back to the other levels at some point.
Hmm.
Oh. Sip, BLT there. Thank you. Appreciate that. He's more what? I got some medicines for you, if you want. Medicine. Oh, you're coughing. We haven't even started smoking yet. Did you, like, just wake up? Oh, wait, no, you didn't. You must have whenever you let the cat in. Tissues are over here. It's an interesting water texture, actually. Because, like, I feel like it's not really supposed to be in that frame rate, but it somehow looks like, simultaneously, it's a little more realistic, but it also still looks kind of like it could exist in a Tomb Raider 4 game. Like, it's not very high res or high frame rate. I don't know why it would be high frame rate. I'm not even sure it's possible to have a higher frame rate water thing. You people Alright, Dave the Daring says, "Stoner's cough. You people disgust me." And then drinks whiskey and throws up. Just thought I'd announce Dave the Daring's, Dave the Daring I've known for many years now. Pretty sure for a while I thought his name was Dave the Darling. Just because I was literally misreading it. Whiskey. What kind? Yoink. Jack D's. Just plain Jack Daniels? Or wait, no. Jack D's. More like Jack D's nuts. Just plain Jack Daniels or any kind of flavor? Because plain is fine. No ice? Well, like, yeah, honestly, as far as I want to say that whiskey is one of the easier liquors to drink warm compared to, like, vodka. But vodka isn't that bad warm, I feel like. I don't know. It's not the end of the world. They're both, you know, gonna go down a little harshly. At least if you're not used to it. Oh, well, I gotta find a hidden lever or some shit. Oh, wait, no, I can... When I have the potato goddess, I can put her on that pedestal, I think. No. But I don't have a potato goddess in this game yet. Sup, John Hobbs. Can we do a 2R3, no loads, no meds tonight? Sure, why not? Let's see. Just right after I find this lever I'm looking for. Oh my god! Got a whole liter. Jesus Christ, I'm not... I was just being sarcastic. Sorry. But anyway. I haven't even opened 2x3 in a long time now. I guess it wouldn't be too hard to run, but... I'd rather do Tomb Raider 3 randomizer if that exists, but I don't. It doesn't yet. All right, I keep thinking there's something in here. Maybe there isn't yet. I may need to come back with something. Oh God. I mean, I could try that. Honestly, that's something I legitimately could try, but it wouldn't. It probably wouldn't go well. I'd probably fucking get destroyed. But it would certainly be interesting. Ah! Well, right now I have a rando setup where it starts in Ice Palace, and there isn't really too much different other than the enemies and stuff until you get to the part with the bridge, and then there's just no bridge, and I wasn't sure where to go from there. So that's all I've seen of the randomizer seed that I got. Is that right? Well, these textures are from Tomb Raider 3, so basically I'm playing Tomb Raider 3 now. For all intents and purposes. Because of those Tomb Raider 3 style wood textures. Surely you agree? It's the best? It's probably... You know what? I'll give you that it has probably the most effort put into the level design of the series. Yeah, I'll say... that's what I'll give it. They worked really hard on Tomb Raider 3. Worked really hard to make the player suffer. But nah, Tomb Raider 3 is pretty dope. I can understand liking it. It's just... A lot of it is... I just feel like a lot of Tomb Raider 3 is unnecessarily tedious. But... meh. I made those levels. Yeah, seriously. It was like... I do get the feeling that Tomb Raider 3 was like their magnum opus for this engine, kind of. Because in Tomb Raider 4, they decided to focus more on atmosphere or whatever. And in my opinion, they were successful, but, I mean, it's not for everyone. Tomb Raider 3 had fine atmosphere, it's just... I enjoy the ambiance of Tomb Raider 4 as well. Oh, Jesus Christ. Wonder if Feeder has heard me talking about how if I was designing a level, I would have two rocks at the top of a hill, and if when you dodge the first one, then another one comes down when you go up a little further. Okay, yeah. He wouldn't do such a thing. Oh, shit. I feel like something's gonna get me. Ow. If you just crawl on the floor, they don't do as much damage to you. Arguably the best. I think there's a case to be made for pretty much any of the first four being the best in some ways. I don't hear many people argue that Tomb Raider 4 is the best, though, honestly. Yeah, okay, Dave. The science of Tomb Raider Judgment. I'll let this kid rot in hell. It is the easiest one, arguably. At least the easiest one to, like, navigate. I don't know, some levels are kind of a clusterfuck like Opera House, but... What the hell? I just went backwards! I went backwards, god damn it. I gotta go over that way. Shit. Well, now I don't know where I last saved, so I'm just... Okay, now it's literally just this stuff. What? Debt John Hobbs. London levels are far and away my least favorite section of Tomb Raider 3. Like, not even close. Do you remember London levels of Tomb Raider 3? You didn't play that shit very much, but...
Oh my god,
yeah, yeah, there's no London in that game. Which is why it's better than Tomb Raider 3. But it is, it's a bit short. Tomb Raider 3 is all epic. But no, the London levels, oh my god. Like, Aldwych... Oh, yeah, big time. What else would it be? Are you goddamn kidding me? I still didn't save after this. Thames Wharf. Probably my least favorite level in the whole of Tomb Raider 3. If you don't take the skin... okay, no, it's not my least favorite. What's it called? Aldwych is much worse. Thames Wharf isn't my least favorite because the beginning of it is kind of fun, where you can just fall into the goddamn abyss and somehow disappear. You're literally on, like, skyscrapers, and there's just no floor. The floor is a chasm. How does that even work? Like, that part is pretty cool, I guess, but that's the only part of... that level that I even play, because you can skip so much of it. Anyway. Like, the parts with the big water tanks that you gotta fill and empty, and it all just boils down to running back and forth a lot and pulling levers. And the but I know that the whole idea is it's all about figuring it out and using your brain, your brain Play-Doh, whatever, brain stuff. But me no brain. Me like shooters. But it's perfectly legitimate to pick any of the first four games. It's just not legitimate to pick Tomb Raider 5 as your favorite. You're not allowed. I can see that. Look, I won't knock the ambience of Tim's work, but when I talk about a level, when I'm judging compared to other levels, I mostly think of how much grief did it cause me when I played it as a kid. And Thames Wharf definitely is up there. Like, because it's one of the first levels you can go to. It is the first level you can go to after India, if you decide to play it in that order. And so as a kid, I would go to that level, and I would just be like, what is happening? How do I do anything? Who turned off all the lights? I used to try to play with low light settings, even though you can turn it all the way up in PC. Okay, is there a purpose to being here? I'm trying to figure this out. Maybe there isn't. But I don't know, there probably is. Oh, of course their goddamn is. Now that's a secret. But what do I get? Please don't just be a health pack. Oh, shit! Okay, it wasn't just a health pack. That's very nice. Okay. So now I guess... I don't even remember what I did. I got a big key, so maybe that means I can go in the house or whatever. Is that just a rock underwater? I'm not sure what I'm looking at. They should remaster Tomb Raider 3. Yeah, that might be interesting. It's got a pretty wild plot. You probably want to change the South Pacific section a little to be a little less redonkulous. Don't change the dinosaurs, obviously. But it's like King Kong. It doesn't play like it used to. Tomb Raider 1 has by far the most cohesive story, which is weird because, I don't know, usually in these types of games, franchises, the first game has less of a story than the later ones. Or, I don't know. Maybe that's not that big of a thing. Tomb Raider 3's Tomb Raider 1's the most user-friendly? I would argue that Tomb Raider 2 is more so, but... Tomb Raider 1 does start at a lower difficulty. Yeah, I guess it has more of a difficulty curve than some of them. Well, what am I saying? It has a difficulty curve. Tomb Raider 2 and 3 do not. Overall. But that's not the point of them. The point of them is to be just wacko. What the fuck? Okay. Oh, is this the place I can open with the key? Or wait, I just need a... Assassin me, girl? Alright. I'm not sure if I've been there already. Or whatever. But... Hero? Hero? Honestly, I would have gone for different ambience tracks for these levels. Just because these ones are... Not that these ones don't fit. I think it's good to use what Tomb Raider 4 has to work with, but I feel like this level is kind of more outdoorsy than the soundtrack makes it seem. I know that soundtrack literally is from an outdoors level, City of the Dead, but it's like... It's not really a serious complaint. Let's see. Oh, okay, I guess this opened. Nice one. Sorry about being preoccupied. Is that the goddamn shotgun? The shotgun looks so tiny in this game. It's really funny. What is... Okay, that's another crowbar door then. Basement key. I just went up a bunch of stairs. I just went up a bunch. Okay, well, actually, this is the huge plantation house, so I was going from, like, the level of the moat, basically. Well, I didn't go all the way upstairs. This is a really big house. So, it's on top of water, so it's like, I don't know, there's, I guess, a bunch of stuff in the basement. Eh. Well, it's not like you're never gonna have that opportunity. Alright. Oh my goodness. Yoink. Whoa. Wow, that's really good. Holy shit. It's got, like, fudge. So you're telling me it literally is... It is packaged to look like one of those granola bars, but it's pure unhealth. It definitely tastes like it, because it tastes like there's fudge in there. New Bond film. Oh, god damn it. Dave the Daring says, I'm going to a midnight showing of the new Bond film in a bit. That's why I'm drinking whiskey, because I don't like Bond, so have to be a bit drunk. Okay, just as long as you ain't driving. New James Bond movie. And he's saying he doesn't like James Bond, so he's getting drunk before going to it. Which I completely identify with it. But, I mean, yeah, I'm not big into game. I'm not big into James Bond, but one of the only ones that I've... The only... What am I saying? The only James Bond I've seen pretty much all the way through was Skyfall, and I saw it in the theater, and you know, I thought it was okay. I thought it was pretty good. Not having seen any of the other ones, I thought it worked okay. I enjoyed... Daniel Craig and the last movie with Agent M in it or whatever. I forget her name. GF is the Bond fan. Well, that's fair enough. God, these are those asshole pipes from trenches that... What the hell? I was always a little confused about the title Quantum of Solace or Solace. What the hell is that title about? Oh, Jesus! For some reason, there's goddamn beetles. Wow. Wasn't really expecting that. I really enjoy the amount of just getting assaulted by enemies there is in this level. Like, there's a lot of enemies hiding just around a corner, and it's like, boo, gotcha. I don't know. That's one of the types of gameplay things that I enjoy. Maybe that's because Tomb Raider 2 did that shit all the time. It's like you just go for a while, and you kind of get lulled into thinking that there's not a lot of enemies around, and then suddenly there's just one right in your face. Oh, nice. Hey, thanks for reminding me that there was oh, Jesus Christ. And for some reason, they brought the zombie in here. Well, I mean, I guess this is just an abandoned, spooky house, so, yeah. NBD. Shut the door! You can't do that shit. So, yeah, there's multiple doors to use that shit on. Oh, man, am I going to have to crawl back through the steam things? No, I'm not. I'm going to just pull this shit out of the way. Oh, man. Ha! Now, I can technically knock them over if I use shotgun shells. But probably not necessary. Are you kidding me? I needed to pull it in the other direction, I guess. Okay, never mind. I guess I can just go behind that shit. Okay. Okay. Oh, not the bats. Anything but the bats. My eyes. My eyes. Oh, come on. Well, now I really am having to deal with bees. Just kidding. They're just locusts, which don't generally bite people. Ow. Wait, what did I get in there besides some ammo? Maybe nothing. Wait, so what was in here? Maybe there's something else? Oh, I guess it doesn't need to be much in here. But then, wait, was that the whole purpose of this? Wait, no. We'll see here. I can't pry this shit open, can I? No. Wait, what the hell? I don't suppose these mummies were killable all along and I didn't realize it, huh? All right, Dave. Enjoy the movie best you can. Wait, so what the hell was the point of that room? There has to be something that I actually gained from going in here. Again, this is not breakable. Okay, whatever. I guess that door's gonna open from the other side or something. Yeah, that's looking great. Huh. Ba-da-da-dum. Da-da-da-dum. 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 Sup, Mango. I haven't been planning on Tomb Raider speedruns, but I am planning on playing more custom levels. Possibly custom level speedruns at some point. I have done a little bit of that lately. Oh yeah, the other thing that I'm interested in doing is Tomb Raider 2 randomizer. Right, let's go use that crowbar, I guess. Is there anything to be gained by jumping over here? This could be a secret. Or just a thing that I need to find. Or it just isn't. Anyway. Crowbar door. Shroud you somewhere. No problem. Well, thanks for joining the stream. Again. Let me see here. Is it here? Finally. I didn't even time that right. If a boulder was gonna kill me underwater, because that can happen. Theoretically. It just wouldn't make a whole lot of sense. Oh boy. Psh, you guys can't even climb. Get the fuck out of here. Dog. I was not expecting that. Well, he's got some grenades. Oh, what the hell? Oh, it rolled way over there. Wonder if there was something I could have gotten there before it rolled. Oh, whatever. Hello? It's a health pack? Oh, shit.
Nabu, what's going on? Gays and girlies. Welcome to the stream. Jesus Christ. I should tell you that he should said you should the pong water. God damn it. Do I look like Tom Green to you? I'm not even sure he ever did that, but it's the kind of thing he would do. So how's everyone doing? Over from Nabu's stream. What were you up to? Fat fucking rip. Yeah, it's Tropicana garlic. It's fairly powerful stuff. But yeah, I cough a lot. Oh shit. Sort of stream got work tomorrow. Wow, sounds like my kind of stream. Since it's games other than Tomb Raider. But, I've never played Dead by Daylight. I could be into it, I don't know. It seems like the most stressful game I've ever heard of. Whether or not you're the killer or the survivor. But I think it's a nice concept, and I'm really fascinated by the fact that it has managed to be a competitive multiplayer survival horror game that's actually successful. I mean, I don't feel like there's really been one that was as consistent at it as it as that one, as Dead by Daylight, since Left 4 Dead 2. Oh, god damn it. What do you know? They made the darts actually poison you. Take notes, Tomb Raider 4 level builders. Darts should actually poison you. I don't care if they do in Tomb Raider 4 or not. Tomb Raider 4 toned down the darts to the point where they're not even a threat, unless in the Tomb Raider level editor you have the fucking machine gun dart trap where it's like, drrrr. I don't know if you remember those, but they're in a lot of level editor games. Okay, well those look like pipes that are gonna have steam come out of them. She the one with the rhombus tits? Oh, of course. I mean, tits and ass, Asian tits. That just sounds like I'm saying Asian. Okay, swimming with the Lara drunk goggles on is definitely tricky. Oh, I got you. Okay, well there you go. Those things are not this instant. All right. Wait, am I gonna be dead? Well, thank you for the follow. Okay, so I'm not exactly sure how to say your name. Chimamir no Namida? Thank you for the follow. Butchering the name pronunciation. Namida. No problem. Okay, Alright, no problem. Oh, god damn it. Wait, I didn't actually get poisoned. Okay, I guess I did. For a second, it didn't seem like I was poisoned, but... Jesus Christ. Now I completely forgot what I was doing. But I'm sure there was something really important over here that I haven't done yet. Anyway, what we're playing, if you're not familiar... Oh, there's goddamn ammo there. I didn't even see. What we're playing is a Tomb Raider 4 The Last Revelation based fan-made level. So this is all just like modded unofficial shit, basically. But it's in the Tomb Raider 4 engine.
Tomb Raider 4 is a game from 1999 that's maybe a ripoff of the 1999 Mummy movie, I guess, but in Tomb Raider form. Hey, at least they didn't make the bad guy Anubis in this version. But this version being Tomb Raider 4. Anyway, right now I'm just playing a level that is based in New Orleans. It's one of them bayou old spooky New Orleans house set in the swamp, so you can have gators and, you know, whatever other enemies you want to deal with. Okay, I finally got the potato. It's purple, so it's basically, you know, what do you call it? A sweet potato. I always mix up sweet potatoes and yams, because they taste kind of similar to me. I don't know what it is. All the secrets? Well, yeah, I absolutely know them, because it took me a few years to figure them out, but I had that much time because that was one of the few games that I actually had when I was really young, was just a disc, which was the Lost Artifact on it, and the Lost Artifact includes Lara's mansion from Tomb Raider 3, and it's just the same. There's no differences. So I got the voodoo gem. Oh geez. All right. Well, we got to get the voodoo gem and put it on top of a thingy, and then it'll be usable. I know this because that's what happened in Tomb Raider 4. This resembles the yellow orb, which we all call the potato. You had to have this. You got this little figurine of a goddess holding the potato. Oh, Jesus. Wow, actually, the camera went underwater during the shotgun blasts, so it drowned out the noise. Oh, right. Also, that's where the boulder trap came from a while ago. Eh. Haha. Probably a secret. Actually, John Hobbs, I've imagined precisely that before. I used to have daydreams of that kind of shit in high school. But that was in the era of, like, the games that were coming out were Tomb Raider Underworld, and then, like, nothing for 4 straight years. And then Tomb Raider. Just Tomb Raider. Oh, Jesus. Have I been using wide shot ammo? Oh, okay. Ow. That's fine. Jesus. I feel like I'm almost still seeing the poisoned effect. Because I left it going for so long last time. Okay, well, I guess this is back where I came from? Or maybe it isn't? I certainly don't remember climbing up here. Okay, I know that. Oh, god damn it. I've climbed up here like a million times. That's so typical. I'm not very good at figuring out where to go in TRLEs, and obviously being stoned just makes me much better at navigating. I mean, duh. That's what happens. When you smoke weed, you get really good at video games. No.
guess I can't really do anything from directly here, but...
Okay, so I used the crowbar on... just one of the doors that I remember opening. But perhaps the front door is the one I need to go to now. Oh, right. It's in here. I remember now. Maybe it isn't in here. It's not in here. This is like a fucking dead end. Because you can't even do anything with a crowbar in here. As far as I can tell. Unless there's like a crowbar door over here and I didn't notice. But that wouldn't even lead me anywhere that's useful. Those enemies are invincible, which is why I'm not bothering to attack them. But they're also incredibly slow and ineffective at attacking you. Okay, well, it's not here. I just ran in here, like a second ago. I guess I'll have to go through the goddamn... crawl space again. Right now, this is a... I was gonna say, John Hobbs, that, I used to sort of imagine that there was a Tomb Raider open world style that just takes place in, like, I don't know, some section of the Valley of the Kings or whatever. There's, like, a bunch of different places you can go to. Maybe you can drive around somehow. I don't know, just some kind of shit where it sorry, trying not to say it too many times or make fun of people who have stutters, which maybe I do, but I don't know. Only when I'm high. Yeah, I guess. I mean, it's not like that hasn't been done, but it would be cool to just have it in a Tomb Raider setting, because I think it would make sense. It doesn't have to be Tomb Raider. It can be your own game or whatever, but it would make a degree of sense for Lara. Okay, finally, I have located the crowbar door. Please don't be a secret. It's going to be a secret, isn't it? It's a secret. But is it a good secret? Because it might be a really good one. I mean... it's not even explosive bolts. Whatever. It's not like it was that hard to find, but... still. I'm gonna have to go back through the... or, no, I don't know where I have to go back through now, because... I have the voodoo gem. Like, it's supposed to be combined with something, or maybe just be somewhere else. Okay, this is just... I vaguely remember being here earlier. I already pulled this lever. And, yeah, this is just outside. I haven't really... fully explored underwater yet, honestly. I always put that shit off. Sometimes so long that I can't even remember that I was gonna do it. But I don't know, yeah, I just sort of imagine something... maybe that would be kind of boring in theory, but, like... having, like, a gameplay phase where finding the entrance to a tomb is your main goal and everything's, you know, hidden. But... maybe it's not that hard to find them initially. almost Shadow of the Colossus-esque. Okay, Shadow of the Colossus is probably not the best example, but a place where you can go to different places, because in that game, you're not, in Shadow of the Colossus, you're not supposed to do it out of order, so it's linear, even though you can go anywhere you want. Okay. So what the hell can I do now? I obviously got to get upstairs. There's probably lots of things. Oh yeah. For one, I'm supposed to try to explore underwater. So that's just a weird rock. Whoa. It's a nice detail. But what happens if I shoot it? Nothing. This just brings us back around to here. Oh, here we go. Sometimes the alligators just break. Oh dear. Well, that was a glitch. Oh wow, how did I miss that shotgun ammo? I guess because it's in the shallow water. Oh, Jesus. Is there another one? Yeah. And there goes my Uzi ammo. Revolver's better anyway, though. Oh, can I actually shoot these? There's a lot of levels have a gimmick where you shoot an object underwater and there's something hidden inside it. Hitting. They're hitting it. It's like hiding, except you just don't say it good. Anywho. I just simply must find some way to get up there. I might have already found the way and not realized it. It's probably somewhere indoors. Since you can go up the stairs and whatnot. Oh god, don't make me call through that area again. It's this place that has, like, a window out to. Oh, can I actually open that from this side? Or probably not. If it's a regular door, not a crowbar door. That looks like it is not a crowbar door. Never watched too many movies. If you're talking about the new ones, I'm not sure. I've only seen, like, the last 15 minutes of the newest Tomb Raider movie. I don't know. I guess it was fun. It was kind of stupid. Kind of bad.
But it was maybe better acted than some of the other older ones. I really like the first Tomb Raider movie. It's kind of a guilty pleasure. I don't know. Critics fucking hated it. Or whatever. But then the second movie was just legitimately terrible. It had Gerard Butler all over it. They just replaced it. It downgraded Daniel Craig to Gerard Butler. It's not like it was the same character, but like Daniel Craig disappeared and was replaced. Gerard Butler's fine. It's a funny contrast. I don't know. It was terrible, but maybe I would have a different perspective if I saw it again. Well, yeah, there you go. Stoic the Vast. Jesus Christ. That was like the best voice casting ever in How to Train Your Dragon. The best use. So I would recommend the first movie, but don't expect like something super amazing, I guess. But I think it captures the games pretty well overall. How familiar are you with the Crystal Dynamics games? Because that would be an interesting thing to compare it to, because I would say it's nothing like the story in those games at all. Those games have Keeley Hawes as Lara Croft, which is hilarious if you've ever seen shit she's been in, like BBC low-budget stuff that British people are just in. Okay, she's not only in that. But yeah. Only really played Tomb Raider 3? Okay. Intradeisting. Well, that means that you stand to have a lot of fun potentially figuring out the other games. If you haven't finished them or whatever. I mean, if you're not into them, that's fine also. But yeah, I can't say it's much like the new ones either. The first Tomb Raider movie, but yeah. Try the first Tomb Raider movie. It's literally about Illuminati confirmed. That's the spoilers. That's what happens in the first Tomb Raider movie. Illuminati confirmed. Except it was in the year 2000, so that wasn't like a idiot meme yet. I mean, it was still an idiot meme kind of, but didn't have the same connotation, I guess. Jesus Christ. Well, I'm not getting anywhere fast. Surprise, surprise. I feel like I already did the thing that I could possibly do here, but maybe not. Let me see. Oh, God. Is it going to turn out that all I needed to do was put this here? No, I actually do need to combine it with something. That's what I suspected. But, like, by the way, when I listened to my stream, I'm pretty sure I was able to actually somehow hear your music. I doubt that the viewers. True. I just wouldn't expect it to be very hearable over the fan. Oh my gosh, okay. First of all, there's probably things underwater that I didn't find. Yoink.
There, guys. Progress. I found some items under the water. Just ammo and a health pack. Alright, I will attempt to find progress, but then I need to BRB. Soon. Stretch my legs and... get more water, for one. Maybe some grub.
Yeah. Could this be beaten? Oh. Hell no! Not unless I just, like, dropped everything and... No, I... Not even close. I have not had a world record since... people of Foodie's caliber have been speedrunning the game. Like, not even close. And in, let alone, even, like... I was, like, one of the first people to post this shit on speedrun.com. At least for Tomb Raider 1. So that was one of the only times I had technically a world record, but it was only... in that very specific single-segment category. It was interesting when you weren't allowed to save in single segment. Well, you were allowed to save and reload in... It wasn't that you weren't allowed to save and reload. You weren't allowed to save or reload in glitchless. I think. I don't know. Because that implied that... It would be, because people say that if you did that, that's not single segment, you're not doing it all in one go. And then later they just stopped caring about that, and way more people were speedrunning it by that point. Did I? Oh, yeah. What the hell is this shit? Probably somewhere I've... Oh, right. This goddamn place. Well, maybe I missed something here. Let's see. Max percent. Jesus Christ. Is that like you get all pickups and shit? Okay. All I gotta do is use my brain power to figure out where to go. Fourth on the no glitch speedrun? Nice. That's surprising. But, oh yeah, for Tomb Raider 3, because it's like 2 hours and some odd. No, I don't even think I had sub 3 hours. I was like 3 hours something. Oh my god. Okay, so now what even? Oh, right, 2 hours. I must be I was mixing it up with Tomb Raider 4 then. How do I make these things open? This is the place I already goddamn went to. I already opened it. And I got something here. Something important. Oh my god. Okay, well, here we are here again. Jesus Christ. Make up the time on London. What now? Was there a bunch of time lost on London? For whatever reason? Okay, that's where I found some Uzi ammo earlier, I'm pretty sure. So, don't need none of that. Yeah, well, London isn't the worst for speedrunning. I just hate London playing casually. Okay, it's actually one of the London levels, what's it called? I'm blanking on it. Aldwych. Aldwych is pretty gross to speedrun, but I guess it's got some interesting glitches now. But, I don't even think Led's Gate is that bad. And Thames Wharf, you skip the entire goddamn level, so that's why it's tolerable. Okay, maybe I should try to just shoot this. Maybe I should have tried this a long time ago. Boom. And it's goddamn motherfucking... It's just some crossbow bolts. Wow, that was pathetic. There you go. Ah, secret though. Oh, maybe they're poison. Poison might actually be nifty, but I have to get the crossbow first. This game has been relatively generous about the guns, like not making the guns secrets. Oh my god. Okay. I'm going to try going upstairs once more. I've been to this room a million times. Nothing in here, really. Except for the thing I already got. Eh. This is not a crowbar door. Just needs something to open it. Let me see here.
water's too damn hot.
But I guess those guys can't even find their way back here anymore. Okay. Let me try this again. First of all, okay, I can't blow that up. Wait a minute here. All right, now I'm just trying to see if that was pushable. So, I forget exactly where this led to, but maybe there's a way I can spin that into helping me get over there. Oh, right. Oh. Let me see here. Okay. Well, it's just flares. Maybe it's meant to make you see something? Sort of? Make you notice something? I don't know. Well, yeah, obviously is on that side of the house. Oh, wow. I'm glad that was deep enough. And here we go. So let me see here. Gosh, maybe that's a crowbar door and I didn't notice. Doesn't seem like it. Really, though. I don't know if you can hear, but there's a little dog yipping out in some neighbor's yard somewhere. Or maybe not even outside. It could just be open window. Okay, this is the one I've been to a million times. I have to have already been to that one. Now we're back on this side of the house. We're pretty much back where we started. Wait a minute. Hang on a second here. You're not telling me I can climb this shit. Okay, now. Wait a minute. Can I climb this shit? Guess not. Wait a minute. Okay, yeah, that's that door. Another one of the doors I have not opened. I guess I have to use the voodoo gem to open them? I don't goddamn know. Oh dear. Okay, what the hell? Get out of here. No collision. Back out goddamn here again. I guess it would be funny if the voodoo gem place actually has the other object you need. I don't know. The other object that you need down in this area, I mean. Or possibly in the other area with the crocodiles. It also could have been in there. I should probably take a break. It might be easier to find the answer. If I do such a thing. By take a break, I just mean BRB. Because I do want to figure this out, but geez. Apparently I'm missing something. I keep feeling like it's in this area, but I don't know, it's just because this area happens to be one of the ones that has a closed door leading to the places I need to get to. A door that is not openable with a crowbar. Oh my fucking god! I found it! I found it! The impossible to find jump switch. The obligatory jump switch that's in a TRLE. That's super hard to see up on a wall. You probably... Yeah, anyway. That really only would mean something. But yeah, one of those ones that's on a wall. They're a pain in the ass to notice. No, probably for progression in the game. I already found all the goddamn secrets, practically, it feels like. Shit, dog. Well, we finally made our progress. Excellent. I got a BRB.
I'm finally back.
Jump over there. What can I do over here? Oh yeah, I forgot to turn the sound back on. Uh-oh. I think I might have crashed the game. For some reason, the game's not responding. All right, then. It's also not exiting. Yeah, it's just not responding. Whatever. I shall attempts to kill it. With fire. Where the hell? Finally. Jesus Christ. Actually, maybe this is an opportunity to switch it back to 32 bits. I don't really see the difference, but we'll see. All right. Ready to rock and roll. Don't be wide shot. Okay, good. Now, what have we here? Probably nothing. Oh, no, 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 no. Well, it's not like I found anything. I can just climb around here, I guess. F'd that up. Obviously, you can use the shimmy, but okay, is this gonna glitch out if I do this? Fingers crossed. Oh, it actually didn't. Don't! Oh my god, I can't believe I did that again. Ayy! No. Just kidding. My instinct is always to goddamn backflip. It's ridiculous. Open sesame. Yay. Found the potato goddess. Oh no, it's more zombies. What happens if I stand here? Oh, this just opens up to the rest of the house. I see. The doors is finally open. Okay, well, what else is out here? Oh, shit. I guess there's not much else. Holy shit balls, that's a lot. Okay, I finally have what I need. I don't really even need to go back inside the house. What am I doing? No, whatever. I just got a beak treak to whichever side is the front door, because I can never remember. Not this side. Or wait, maybe it wasn't at the front door. It was in the trap door that's somewhere else. But there's a trap door somewheres. Okay, maybe I'm going the wrong way to get to that trap door. Or no, maybe I'm going the right way. Maybe it's this. No, this doesn't look right. Well, no, this is right. It's just like maybe you have to go so roundabout. Sweet potato goddess. Ooh, spooky. Ooh, ooh. It's not even October yet. We're near the end of spooky September, I guess. What? Who done it? What is it? Hello? Oh, it's one of them guys. Okay. That's probably worthy of goddamn revolver. Holy shit, it looks weird as hell. Stop missing, Lara. Jeez. Alright, so what is the actual best way to go from here? Probably down. Wait, not here. What, yes, here. Doink. I have to fight a spooky ghost.
After placing a voodoo doll with a sweet potato on it.
What? It was a voodoo doll and a voodoo gem. But the gem is based on a yellow gem in Tomb Raider 4 that resembles a potato. And people call it, people meaning me, I call it a potato. So this is just that, except it's purple. So it's a sweet potato. I guess the outside of the sweet potato isn't that purple.
But it's sort of purple. Let's see. All right. All I gotta do is get into a position where it's like not... Yeah, there we go. Wait, nope. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Terminated, fucker. Whoa, what the hell? That was fucked up. I don't suppose the level exit is just right here. Wait a minute. Maybe that sound effect was actually some a block somewhere raising, and maybe it was a secret or some shit. Okay, maybe it wasn't at all. I don't know. Could be. Then what's over here? Maybe it was actually just this opening. Oh, this is where I use the scripture. Good thing I got that. Sorry, just checking for secrets. Or whatever. Now, I don't suppose there's anything that we gained from not placing it right away. Okay. No. She always says no when you use that item. It's just a glitch. Oh, wait, this is just the end of the level. In my case, I do wonder about secrets. I don't know. Probably not anything, but... I'll use the binoculars to quickly just check around the room. I don't know. Don't know, don't care no more. It's over.
It's over.
I really expected that to go on longer. But I guess I placed the voodoo thing. I guess all the shit that I missed in those levels was secrets. Whoops. Oh well. That's really funny.